Hello students, in today's lecture of maths we are going to learn the addition of rational numbers. Okay, see here first example, some examples I have written on the blackboard. This board, first example is 1 upon 8 plus 3 upon 4. So these are two rational numbers. Once again I repeat, rational numbers means the numbers which can be expressed in the form of numerator and denominator, where denominator must not be equal to 0. That is in the form of p upon q, where q is not equal to 0. That is called rational number. So these are rational numbers and we are going to learn how to add them. Now this, as we have added fraction, same method we are going to use here to add the rational numbers. Okay. See here how to add. Now we have seen that to add the fractions, the denominators must be equal. Okay, that means they must be like fractions. Same here to add the rational numbers, they must be like rational numbers. Means the denominators must be equal. Okay, so here denominator is 8, here denominator is 4. They are not equal. Then how to make it equal? By finding the LCM. LCM of the denominators. Here 8 and 4. What is LCM of 8 and 4? Yes, LCM of 8 and 4 is 8 itself. Okay, so LCM of 8 and 4 is 8. That's why we have to make the denominator equal to the LCM, that is 8. Now in the first rational number already denominator is 8, so keep it as it is. In the second rational number denominator is 4. To make here 8 we need to multiply it by 2. So in the numerator also multiply by 2. So 1 by, now see, denominator is common, here 8, here also 8. So take it common and add the numerator. 1 plus 3 2s are 6, which is equal to 7 upon 8. Okay? See, second example. This is one of the method where we can find the LCM to make the denominator equal. See the second example. 1 upon 5 plus minus 4 upon 7. These are two integers and we have to add them. Now see, here also the denominators are not equal. So here LCM means what? See, the denominators, here there is 5, here there is 7. Both are prime numbers, right? Both are prime numbers. Means to find their LCM, we need to multiply both the numbers. How we find LCM of prime numbers? Just their multiplication. So here, what we need to do, as their LCM is what? Their multiplication. So directly, instead of finding their LCM, what we are going to do? We are going to do the cross multiplication. See how to do the cross multiplication. 1 multiplied by 7 plus minus 4 multiply by 5 upon 5 into 7. Understood what we have done? 1 into 7 is cross multiplication. 1 into 7 plus minus 4 into 5. Okay? Upon 5 into 7. Is this way and this. Denominator into denominator. Is equal to 7 ones are 7 plus 4 into minus 5, minus 20 upon 5 7 plus 35. 7 plus and into minus, plus minus, minus 20 upon 35. Now 7 minus 20 is minus 30 upon 35. Okay, do you understand why a minus sign? Because 20 in these two integers, 20 is greater, it has negative sign, that's a negative answer. So minus 13 upon 35. So here, when we can use this method of cross multiplication, when the denominators are, any one denominator is prime, or both the denominators are prime. Okay, not any one, both the denominators must be prime, then we can use this method. Here also, in this case also we can use the cross multiplication method, but again while finding, after getting answer, again we need to find lowest term. We will not get lowest term if we use this method in this case. Okay, so where generally if denominators are prime numbers, then only you can use this method. Okay, so when denominators are prime numbers, then prefer to this method. Now see this third one example. 2 integer 1 by 8 plus 3 integer 1 by 18 plus minus 2 integer 1 upon 24. Okay, so if you see, these are the mixed fractions or mixed rational numbers. So let's see how to add such type of rational numbers where one of the part is whole part and then fractional part means mixed rational number. So what to do, you know, first in this rational number, first we will add their whole parts. Okay, so in the whole part, 2 plus 3 minus 2, okay, plus we will, in the second bracket we will add the fractional part. Okay, so 1 by 8 plus 1 by 18. Now this 1 upon 24, since this minus 2 integer 1 upon 24 means this minus sign belongs to both rational number. Okay, both 2 also and 1 upon 24 also. So here 1 upon 24 will be negative, minus. Fine. Here we will get 3 plus 2, 5, 5 minus 2, 3. Plus, in the second bracket C, 1 upon 8 plus 1 upon 18 minus 1 upon 24. Okay. To add or subtract this, here, first we need to make the denominators equal by finding the LCM. So can you tell me can you guess what is the LCM of 8, 18 and 24? Okay, generally how to gauge the LCM? See the largest number in this, out of this 3, see the largest number 24. Check whether 24 is in table of remaining two numbers. Is there 24 in table of 18? No. It is in table of 8 but not in 18. That's why 24 cannot be LCM. Then do 24 twos are. What is 24 twos are? 24 twos are 48. Now check whether 48 is in table of 18 or 8 and 8. It is in table of 8 but not in 18. The 24 threes are 72. So if you check, 72 is in table of 18 also and 8 also, right? So LCM of 8, 18 and 24 is nothing but 72. That means we have to make the denominator 72. So 8 into 9 is 72. So here also multiply by 9 plus 18, 4s are 72. So here also 4s are minus 24, 3s are 72. Understood? Is equal to 3 plus. Now denominator is equal. 72 is 72. 8, 9 is 72. 18, 4 is 72. 24, 3 is 72. Take it common. 9 ones are 9 plus 4 ones are 4 minus 3 ones are. Okay, so 3 plus 9 plus 4 is 9 plus 4 is 30 and 30 minus 3. 9 plus 4 is 30 and 30 minus 3 again 10 upon 72. Okay, now see this 10 and 72 are divisible by 2. 2 5s are and 2 36s are. So 3 plus 5 upon 36, that is 3 whole 5 upon 36. Okay. So in this way, we have to add the mixed rational numbers. See, here I have taken 3 types of examples, 3 different examples. In the first example we have solved using by making the denominators equal. Okay, then in the second example, we have used cross multiplication method to add. So when we can use cross multiplication method? When denominators are prime numbers. And in the third, there are mixed rational numbers. So we have learned to do the addition or subtraction of the mixed rational numbers. Okay, so now pause this video and write these examples in your notebook. After that, we will see the properties of addition of rational numbers. So now let's see the properties for the addition of rational numbers. Here I have written the names of the properties: closure property, commutative property, associative property, property of zero, and negative of rational numbers. These five properties we are going to see in the case of addition of rational numbers. So first, let us understand the meaning of each property. What is mean by closure property? We have seen this property in the case of integers last year. Okay. Closure property says, I'll tell you first about the integer. Okay. About the integer, closure property means what? If we add two integers, if we add two integers, the answer is the answer which we are getting, it is also an integer. Understood? This is closure property. Now see, if we add two integers, if answer is also an integer, then we can say that integers are closure under addition. And we have seen that yes, this property is applicable for the integers in the case of addition. We see integers are closure under addition. So similarly, for rational number, we are going to check whether if we add two rational numbers, whether we get answer rational number. Okay, so let's see. First, let's take one example. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3. Suppose these are two rational numbers. Let's add them. 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3, plus 2 ones are 2, upon 3 twos are 6. 3 plus 2 5 upon 6. So when we added these, we got answer 5 upon 6, and we know that 5 upon 6 is also in the form of p upon q. Right? Means it is also rational number. That means what? Rational numbers are closure under addition. If a and b, a upon b and c upon b are two rational numbers, a upon b and c upon b are two rational numbers, and if we add it, then what? The answer of which we will get, it will be also rational number. Right? When in the addition of these two rational numbers, a upon b plus c upon d, answer which we will get, it will be also rational numbers. So we can say that rational numbers are closure under addition. Okay. Now let's see second property, commutative property. Commutative property means what? It is these two properties actually, commutative property and associative property. Both properties are related with the order of the numbers. Order means sequence. For example, commutative property says that if a and b, a upon b plus c upon b, means a upon b and c upon b are two rational numbers. If we add them, the answer which we will get, it is equal to c upon b plus a upon b. Understood? Means this is one rational number, this is one rational number. If we change the sequence, first we have taken this c upon b, we have taken here first and a upon b in the second. And if we added them, the answer of these and answer of these will be exactly equal. That is what commutativity. Understood? So for example, if you want to take, same example we take 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3. So here what answer we are getting? 5 upon 6. Now by changing the sequence, changing the order, let's check what answer we are getting. 1 by 3 we take first, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 2. What we have done? We have changed the order. Now what we are getting? Let's see. 2 ones are 2 plus 3 ones are 3 upon 3 twos are 6. 2 plus 3, 5 upon 6. Are we getting same? This and this, it is equal. So though we change the order of the rational number in addition, even though we change the order, the answer doesn't change. Answer remains same. That means we can say that rational numbers are commutative under addition. Rational numbers are commutative under addition. Okay? Have you understood meaning of commutativity? Commutativity means It is property related with the sequence, order of the numbers. Here, even though we change the order, answer doesn't change, answer remains same. That's why rational numbers are commutative under addition. Okay? So this properties we are going to use while simplifying the rational numbers. We are going to use to make the example easy. Okay? Associative property. Third property is associative property. It is also the property related with the order of the rational numbers. But here, when rational numbers are more than 2, means 3 or more than 3, in that case we have to use this means a m of d plus c m of d plus e upon f. Suppose there are 3 rational numbers. Then, first if we added these two, first and second rational number we have added first, and later we have added e upon f in that. It will be equal to this. Means, as there are 3 numbers, first we have grouped first 2 rational numbers and then third rational numbers we have added in that, and here on this side we have grouped second and third one rational number. This second and third one rational number we will add first, and in that we will add first one. So, though here groups are different in the addition of 3 or more rational numbers, groups are different. You can make groups in this way anyhow, even though you will get answer same. That we have to check. Let's check first. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. These 3 rational numbers we will take. And first we are going to add first 2. Okay, going to this. What we are getting? 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 we have found here. 5 upon 6. 5 upon 6. And in this we will add 1 by 4. Okay. So what we will get? 4 5s are 20. Plus 6 1 plus 6 upon 6 4 plus 24, which is equal to 26 upon 24. By finding lowest sum, we will get 30 upon 12. Okay. Now let's check if we group these 3 rational numbers in this way, are we getting same answer? Let's see. What we are going to do? A upon 1 by 2. Plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. Means we have group second one and third one rational number first. So what we are going to do? We are going to add these two rational numbers first. Okay. So 1 by 2 carry forward as it is. 4 ones are 4 plus 3 ones are 3 upon 3 fours are 12. 1 by 2 plus 4 plus 3 7 upon 12. So we got answer of this 7 upon 12. So in this 7 upon 12, now we will add 1 by 2. 2 7s are 14. 12 1s are 12. Okay, 12 1s are 12. 2 7s are 14 upon 12 2s are 24. 12 plus 24 is 20. So 12 plus 14 is 26 upon 24. And 26. 13 and here 12. So this 13 upon 12 is exactly equal to this 13 upon 12. So this proves that, hence it is proves to prove that though we group anyhow the rational numbers which are given there, which are more than 3, though we group anyhow, the final answer which we get it is equal. So hence we can say that rational numbers are associative under addition. So when we are going to add the 3 or more rational numbers, we can group them anyhow according to our easiness. Okay. So the other examples based on this associativity or commutativity are in the exercise. We will take such examples and later we will see how these properties are applicable there, useful there to save our time. Okay. Now next property is property of 0. Property of 0 means what? In the case of integer, we have seen property of 0 this one. If we add 0 in the integer, the answer we get same number. If we add 0 in any integer, the answer is that integer itself. Similarly here, if we add, suppose a upon b is any rational number, if we add 0 in that, or in 0, we will add any rational number. What answer will we get? A upon b plus 0 or 0 plus a upon b, what will we get? A upon b itself, right? Means if we add any number in 0 or if we add 0 in any rational number, the answer is that rational number itself, okay? For example, 1 by 2 plus 0 is plus or 0 plus 1 by 2, answer is 1 by 2, okay? So here, when we add 0 in any rational number, the answer is that number itself, it doesn't change. So, 0 is called additive identity. 0 is called additive identity of the rational numbers. Additive identity or of the rational numbers or identity element. 0 is called additive identity. Or identity element. Such question can be asked for the filling the blanks or MCQ. Would dash dash is the additive identity of rational numbers? Or dash dash is the identity element of rational numbers? So what is that? Zero. Okay. And the fifth one is negative of rational numbers. If a upon b is rational number, its negative is minus a upon b. A upon b is negative is minus a upon b. And if we add this, what answer will you get? A upon b plus minus minus a upon b, which is equal to 0. Okay? So if we add negative in the rational number, if we add this negative, you are getting answer 0. Okay? So this negative is then called additive inverse. Okay, additive inverse means what? If we add additive inverse in that rational number, you will get answer 0. It may be additive inverse of a upon b is minus a upon b, or vice versa. Means if it is minus a upon b, its additive inverse is a upon b. Okay, generally additive inverse means such number, when we add in that, we get answer 0. Okay, if you add two numbers, these two, you will get answer 0. All these two, if you add, you get answer 0. So such numbers are called additive inverse of each other. Okay? For example, if it is 1 by 2, its additive inverse is minus 1 by 2. If it is minus 3 upon 4, its additive inverse is 3 upon 4. Okay? Understood? What is additive inverse of 0? Think and take the answer while problem solving period. Okay? So now write these properties in your notebook, write properly. After that you will see subtraction and its properties.
Let's see now subtraction of rational numbers. It is same like addition. The methods which we have used while doing addition of rational numbers, same methods we have to use here. We can make the denominator equal by finding LCM, or if the denominators are prime numbers, we can use cross multiplication method. Okay, see the first example, 3 upon 5 minus 5 upon 7. So see here, as the denominators are rational or prime numbers, so use cross multiplication method. 7 3s are 21 minus 5 5s are 25 upon 7 5s are 35 is equal to 21 minus 25. These are two integers, 21 minus 25. Answer is minus 4 upon 35. Finish. So minus 4 upon 35 is the answer. Second, minus 7 upon 12 minus 1 upon 8. Okay. Here you can find LCM of 12 and 8. what is LCM of 12 and 8? To make the denominators equal, we need to find LCM of 12 and 8. What is 12? 1's are 12, 12, 2's are 24. 24 is in table of 8 also. That's why LCM is 24. So let's make denominator 24. 12, 2's are 24. So here, minus 1 by 8, 8, 3's are 24. Okay? So my 7, 2's are 14, minus 14. Upon here 24, 24 take it common, minus 14, minus 3 ones are 3. Minus 14, minus 3, two integers with same sign, and add them, 14 plus 3, 17. So minus 17 upon 24 is the answer. So as we have done addition of rational numbers, in the same way we can do the subtraction of rational numbers. Okay, write these two examples, after that we will see properties of rational numbers for the subtraction.
Let's see now the properties for the subtraction of rational numbers. Okay, as we have seen these properties in the case of addition of rational number, let's see are they applicable in the case of subtraction of rational numbers. Okay, first see the closure property. As we have seen closure property, if we subtract two rational numbers, are we getting rational number itself? Let us check. For example, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, minus 1 by 3, okay, 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3, if we subtract these two rational numbers, what do we get, is equal to 3 ones are 3, minus 4 ones are 4, upon 4 threes are 12, so 3 minus 4, minus 1 upon 12. So minus 1 upon 12, is it rational number? Is it in the form of P upon Q, where Q is not equal to 0? Yes, it is. Minus 1 upon 12, it is also rational numbers. That means what? If we subtract two rational numbers, the answer is also rational number. That means rational numbers are closure under subtraction. As it is closure under addition, they are closure under subtraction also. Okay, let's see about commutativity and associativity. If in the subtraction, if we change the sequence, see 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3, the answer we have got minus 1 upon 12. Okay, but if we change the order, 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4, if we done, then will we get same answer? Let's check it. 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 is equal to 4 ones are 4 minus 3 ones are 3 upon 3 fourths are 12, which is equal to 4 minus 3, 1 by 12. So it is not equal. See, minus 1, 1 by 12 is not equal to 1 by 12, because this is negative, this is positive, they are not equal. That means what, you know, if we change the order of rational numbers, two rational numbers in the subtraction, their answers are not equal. So the commutative property is not applicable here. So we can say that rational numbers are not commutative under subtraction. They are commutative under addition, but not under subtraction. Okay. Same will be under associative property, because here also the properties, these properties are also related with the order sequence. That's why they will not be associative also. Let's check once again. 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2. So here, you know, how do we solve this? First we will solve this two. 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3, we have got minus 1 upon 12 minus 1 by 2. Okay? 2. 2 ones are 2, so minus 2. And 12 minus 12 is 12 upon 12 2 is 24. So minus 2, minus 12, minus 14 upon 24. Okay. Now here, 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2. So if we add or if we subtract these two, last, second one and third one, what will happen? See, minus 2 1 are 2 minus 3 3 1 are 3 upon 3 2 are 6 so 1 by 4 minus 2 minus 3 minus 1 upon 6 okay so 1 by 4 minus minus plus 1 by 6 6 1 are 6 plus 4 1 are 4 upon 6 4 are 24 okay so here we are getting 10 upon 24 so this minus 14 upon 24 is not equal to 10 upon 24 okay that means associative property is also not applicable so we can say that rational numbers are not associative under subtraction okay so we can here see that rational numbers are closure under subtraction but not under commutative so not commutative and associative under subtraction okay and then fourth one property is existence of right identity in the case of addition we have seen that zero is the identity element for the addition or additive identity for the rational numbers but here in the subtraction if we subtract 0 from 1 by 2 0 from 1 by 2 what answer will you get 1 by 2 but if we subtract 1 by 2 from 0 or means 0 minus 1 by 2 what answer will you get minus 1 by 2 that means when see 1 by 2 minus 0 when 0 is on the right in this example when 0 is on the right side then only answer the answer is getting that number itself in the subtraction. When 0 is on the left, we are not getting answer that number itself. We are getting minus 1 by 2. Okay? Understood? That means in the subtraction, there is existence of only right identity. If 0 is on the right, then only the answer is that number itself in the subtraction. Here the minus sign is for subtraction. Okay? So, in the subtraction, there is existence of right identity, which we call 0. Okay? Now write these identities in your notebook. So today we have learned the addition, their properties, addition of rational number, their properties in the case of rational number, then we have done subtraction and properties of subtraction in the case of rational number. Okay? I hope you have understood this. Mainly here there is addition and subtraction and commutative property and associative property in the case of addition. Zero is also important, identity element is also important, additive inverse is also important, okay? But most important is associative property and commutative property because the properties we are going to use while simplifying the rational numbers, we are going to use so that the examples, the complicated examples we can solve easily, okay? So now write these properties in your notebook and tomorrow we have to solve the exercise which is based on this. Okay.